disobedience to the word of God, it is not the Holy Ghost you have. Because the flesh, the carnality in you will always manifest. The spirit in you will always manifest. When the spirit in you is manifesting disobedience to the word of God, it is as a result of that spirit. Hallelujah. But if the spirit in you is being obedient to the word of God, it is as a result that you have Christ in you. So what spirit is really dwelling in you? Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost is given to those that obey the word of God. Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost is not given to those that are rebelling against the word. The Holy Ghost is not given to those that are living a life that is not pleasing before God. The Holy Ghost is Christ in you, the hope of glory. The Bible said, if the spirit that rose Christ from the grave dwelleth in you, it shall quicken your mortal bodies. That spirit is the spirit of God. Now Romans 8 tells us, Romans 8 verse 1 says, and there is now therefore now no condemnation to those that are in Christ Jesus. To be in Christ Jesus is to have the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. 2 Corinthians 5:17 there says, those that are in Christ Jesus, they are new creature. Old things are passed away. All things become new. To be in Christ Jesus is to be born again. You are not fulfilling the lust of the flesh anymore, but you are fulfilling the desire of the spirit. Therefore, there is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, who does not walk according to the law of the flesh. Hallelujah. But fulfill the desire of the spirit. That is to be born again. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ was telling the disciples, he said, watch and pray that ye enter not into temptation. Hallelujah. He said, the spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak. Your flesh is weak. Walk on your flesh. Your flesh is weak. Walk on your flesh. We know the fruit of the flesh. The fruit of the flesh will always manifest. The fruit of the flesh is as a result of the spirit that is dwelling in you. We started on telling you that there are two spirits, and these two spirits, they are looking for a body to dwell in. The spirit of God, hallelujah, that is Christ in you, the hope of glory. And the spirit of Satan, that is flesh. Both of them are trying to prevail. Which of them, either of them that you allow to prevail, it will prevail and it will rule in your life. So are you allowing flesh to prevail? And it will manifest. It will manifest. If you have the spirit of Christ, it will manifest love, peace, long-suffering, patience, tolerance. But if you have the spirit of Satan in you, it will always manifest wrath, unforgiveness, drunkenness, perversion, hallelujah, gossip, backbiting, and many of the rest. Brothers and sisters, how can you not please your ways? How can you not live a life pleasing before God? By taking heed to his word. That is how you can get rid of flesh. Obey the word of God. Practice holiness. Practice righteousness. Practice godliness. Do your best to love one another. Do your best to live a life pleasing before God. And ask God, wherever the flesh is struggling with the spirit, ask God to give you the grace to overcome flesh. Because if you are born again, the flesh is dead. Hallelujah. If you are born again, the Bible says, Colossians 3, 1 to 3, says, if ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ seated on the right hand of God. Set your affection on the things above, not on the things on the earth. For we are dead, and your life is hid with Christ, as Christ is hid in God. Let us bow down our head and talk to the Lord. Father, kill my flesh. and let your spirit come alive in me. I don't want to live in flesh anymore. Because that flesh is as a result of the spirit inside of you. If the spirit of God is in you, it will manifest spirits. Hallelujah. But if it is flesh that is in you, it will manifest flesh. If it is flesh that is dwelling inside of you, that flesh will be made manifest. The Bible said that which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the spirit is spirit. If it is flesh, if you are born of the flesh, you will continually manifest flesh, no matter how many tongues you speak. But if you are born of the spirit, you will continually manifest the fruit of the spirit. Talk to the Lord. Talk to the Lord and tell the Lord, I want to manifest the fruit of the spirit. Love, peace, long-suffering, temperance, joy, accommodating, patience. Hallelujah. Talk to the Lord. Tell the Lord to take away flesh, because the flesh is always trying to come up. We took a teaching, your old man is dead. Do not resurrect it. That old man is flesh. Don't resurrect it. Hallelujah. That old man is flesh. Tell the Lord, I don't want my old man to reign. I want the spirit to continue to reign. Break me, Lord. Mold me again. Let my sinful nature die. Let only your spirit come alive in me. Break me and mold me. Hallelujah. Incubate me. Incubate me with your spirit. Tell the Lord, you know me. You know me. You know I'm full of flesh. If you are struggling with flesh, the Lord will help you. But if you are filled with flesh and you want to, our God to deliver you, God is still able to deliver you. But are you willing? Those that are willing shall eat the fruits. Are you willing? Talk to the Lord if you are willing. Then the Lord help me. I don't want to live in the flesh anymore. I want to live in the spirit. Father, help me. Let my flesh die. Let the spirit of God come upon me. Flesh is disobedience. Flesh is rebelliousness. Flesh is you. Your flesh is your desire, your own will. I, me, myself, and I. Flesh is carnality. Hallelujah. Tell the Lord, I don't want flesh to prevail anymore. I am tired of living in this body of flesh. I am tired of living in this body of flesh. I want to live in the spirit. Hallelujah. I want to desire the things of the spirit. I want to desire love, peace, joy, long-suffering, tolerance. I want to desire how to close my mouth and not to gossip. I want to desire how to close my mouth and not to stab another. I want to desire how to pray for one another. Hallelujah. And as you continue to do this, the Lord will help you. Mind you, the Holy Ghost is given to those that obey. If you are living in rebelliousness and you say you have the Holy Ghost, you have another spirit, another ghost, not the Holy One. Bow down your head and let us pray. Everlasting Father, we thank you for this wonderful message. We thank you for our brother, as many that has listened to the sound of our voice today, our brothers and sisters here and far away, all over the world that joined us today. Father, we know that many of us are still struggling in the flesh. Help us, O Lord. Let flesh die, because your word made us to know that those that are in the flesh cannot fulfill the law of God. Hallelujah. And for us to be in the flesh, we have created enmity between us and God. We don't want to have enmity between us and God. We don't want to fulfill the law of the flesh, but we want to fulfill the law of the spirit, which comes to us through grace. Father, help us. Father, help us. Let our sinful nature continue to die daily, that the Spirit of God will come alive in us, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. As we desire to live a life pleasing before God, God will help us to fulfill our destiny in Jesus' name. God bless you, brothers and sisters. God bless you. God bless you. Are you desiring to live a life pleasing before God? The Bible said in the book of Acts, repent of your sins. Repent of your fleshy attitudes. And be baptized in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. The word of God says, for the remission of your sins, you need to be baptized. Hallelujah. Repent of that fleshy attitude. Then be baptized in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Not Father, not Son, not Holy Ghost, but in Jesus' name. Look at the scripture. It was done in Jesus' name. For the remission of your sin. That is the importance of baptism. For the sins that we inherited from Adam and Eve to be remitted, to be washed away. The Bible said, after that, you can ask God for the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is Christ in you, the hope of glory. When the Holy Ghost comes upon you, you will not fulfill the lust of the flesh anymore, but you will continue to fulfill the desire of the Spirit, because it is not you that liveth anymore, but Christ that liveth in you. And the life you live in flesh, you will live by faith in the Son of God that loved you. Hallelujah. No more your will, but the will of God. Father, we thank you for that brother, that sister, that want to live a life pleasing before God, that doesn't want to continue in flesh. You know, flesh is interesting. That smoke you are smoking to lead you to hell. That drunkenness, that lasciviousness, that unforgiveness, that covetousness, with all the money, it will lead you to hell. You need God. Talk to the Lord. Cry unto him. Look for a living church and get baptized. And after that, ask for the Holy Ghost. When he comes inside of you, you will know. You will know that spirit that will cause you to obey the word. That's how you know that Christ is in you. And you will know that you will not fulfill the lust of the flesh anymore. That is why the Bible said, those that are in Christ Jesus, they are new creature. All things are passed away. That fleshy nature will pass away and everything will become new. The Lord will help you in Jesus' name. God bless you, brothers and sisters. Write us, tell us what you feel concerning our message. And if you have any question, ask us and we'll always answer you. And if you need prayer, contact us and we'll join hands with you and pray. And the Lord will visit you, bring deliverance to you, to your home, to your marriage, to your ministry, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you. We give you all the glory. In Jesus' name. I want us to pray for this month. As the month is coming to an end, we all desire many things. And many of us, maybe your expectation has not been fulfilled. The Bible said the expectation of the righteous shall not be cut off. Hallelujah. Continue to believe. Continue to strive. His mercy will bring forth all your desire in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I join my faith with you and I pray that all everything that you are believing God for, the mercy of God will cause you to receive it in Jesus' name. I pray for speed. I pray for restoration. I pray for healing. I pray for deliverance. I pray for miracle. I pray for testimony. And I pray for all-round victories in every facet of your life in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, everlasting Father, for in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.